Welcome back to the O2. An expectant crowd here and at home for the first tournament final of this new format in snooker. Power Snooker reaches its fulcrum here in a couple of minutes. Let's get the players out to meet you. The final two, starting with the man they call the Rocket. I've been roaming around on looking down at all I see. Right hand, left hand, he's got the lot. When he's at it, very few, if any, snooker player can live with this man. Three-time champion of the world. I know you want to give it up now for Ronnie O'Sullivan. That's Ronnie, his final opponent here tonight, also a gifted snooker player. Let's meet the man from China. Twice winner of the UK Championship and a runner-up in this year's China Open in Beijing. Now a resident of that snooker city that is Sheffield. He's here tonight for you, Ding Shunhui. Formalities almost your over. Choice. Just remains for me to say that Michaela Tabb will take charge of this final match here at the O2. Handshakes all round and on commentary duties for us. I'm delighted to say that Ali Carter will join Peter Drury.
Thank you.
It is a delight to have him
Ding Junhui
on board, co-piloted by the captain for the final. The culmination of a day of experimentation. We've sucked it and seen. On the whole, I think we've had a bit of a ball. And now we seek to crown the bow of the ball. And based on your experience today, Ali, the favourite must be the main man, Ronnie.
Yeah, I mean, Ronnie's playing very, very well. You've got to expect him to take this, really. But having said that, Ding's got had a good split there, and he's banging the balls ready to go.
Eight.
Must be a particular pressure that goes with
nine.
Having an opportunity against Ronnie O'Sullivan. Cannot afford to pass them up.
No, not at all. The table's just caught Ding out a little bit there. He played for the black, but he's got a little bit of a tougher pink here.
Did you have the sense when you were up on stage with Ronnie that he was in one of those moods
15.
Where he wasn't going to be caught?
Yeah, I mean, the Rocket was in great form, wasn't he? He
16.
Potted just about everything against me and never really gave me much chance. So, vital that Ding gets off to a good start here.
So, whilst he is seated to start with, the Rocket is nevertheless enjoying the ambience around this final.
To.
But it is Ding who is enjoying being amongst the balls.
23.
Yeah, we'll be looking to get on the power ball here somewhere soon. Maybe pop this pink, another red, and then maybe try and get back on the power ball. So try and get the points racked up.
It's been notable a few times over the course of the day how stubborn the power ball has been. It's got into
29.
The habit once or twice of hiding. Ding is trying to find a way to
30.
Maneuver towards it here.
Yeah, I think he'll play the loose red here just above the black, play on that, maybe get behind the black and then over for the power ball, or certainly the red near the power ball. Well, there we go, he's gone for it there, but I don't know if this red goes. It obviously
37.
Does, the way he's queuing up for it. Here it comes.
He's left the gate open. It's a multiply. Now the numbers get big.
Yeah, that's a great shot there. He's bang on the black now. And ready to rack the points up, quick sharp.
Oh, this is a massive chance. A massive chance for China's Ding Junzhi to get away from the favourite. Put a lot of daylight between him and Ronnie.
It'd be 59. Interesting to see Ronnie's response to this, because this is the first time he's going to be behind going into the second rack, I think, and under a little bit of pressure. So it'd be interesting to see how he reacts to that.
69.
For the first time in power snooker, Ronnie O'Sullivan is going to be chasing the game. Against the clock, under a bit of pressure.
Oh.
But not perhaps to the extent that he feared.
So is the rocket going to come off the launch pad?
Is Ding going to rue that miss? 69 points, very comfortable plumped up cushion, but it might have been more.
Yeah, I think he'd be looking to play a good safety here, Ding. Yeah, the white's just going to run on and on there, a little flick off the brown, hopefully behind the yellow.
Harrison.
No, just crept by the yellow. So Ronnie's got a chance here of a shot to nothing, or for the white to get all the way back and into the power zone.
Of course, it is a two-sided coin, getting the white back behind the balk line in power snooker. On the one hand, of course, there is a safety element to it, but on the other, it doubles the score of any pot that follows.
A little bit of safety involved here, I think. The rocket might try and split up the green and the brown here with the white ball to hold it up the top end.
Power zone.
Good safety there from Ding. I think Ronnie might have a go at this red.
Discretion, the better part of valour.
Power zone.
Five minutes gone. Ronnie's not on the scoreboard yet. He is now.
What's he done there?
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 8.
Rocket's got a chance here now to get his first scoring.
Gifted the opening. Just gifted the opening.
One.
There's a danger now that...
Oh, he might be rolling up behind the brown here, yep.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 1.
And that wasn't very nice, was it?
It does mean that all of Ding's early good work just might be undone, though Ronnie applauds his escape.
Oh, has he got away with it here? Yeah, it's just crept by the middle bag, so Ding's going to have to play a safety here.
Power zone.
Thank you. really interesting watching the interaction between the players today, Ali. And in particular, I suppose, watching Ding, because clearly with a language problem, it's hard for him to be involved in quite the same way with the banter that you guys have between you. But even taking that into account, there's a twinkle in his eyes, and there's a bit of mischief, and he's clearly grown into there and really loved it as much as the other seven.
Oh, definitely. I mean, Ding's coming out of himself a little bit here. He's got a bit of an advantage, not being able to speak much English, so he can't really hear what the crowd are saying. So that might do us a favour if they take this tournament to China.
Good thought.
Why not, eh? I don't think Ding's trying to cheat here. He's just trying to pop the red.
One.
Bit of banter from the crowd. Yeah, Ding's got a nice chance here to clear these reds up and put Ronnie further under the cosh.
You had a little circuit of the table at one stage, didn't you, to see off a few seconds, and why wouldn't you?
Well, exactly. I mean, I've done a little lap of honour there, really. That was what it was all about, rather than trying to use the seconds up, but it seemed to do both. So,
well, I said at the time, top sportsmen in whatever sport will take the rules and use them to their advantage where they possibly can.
Well, eight. Exactly, definitely. All what's happened here, is he going to creep past the brown? Yeah, he's perfect there.
How is that?
We'll see what the rocket's made of when he smashes the pack up off the next break-off.
This is worth eight.
22.
They love their brown ball in the stalls.
They do like the brown. I don't know why, but they like the brown, all right.
27.
Pink and black for a lead of precisely 100 after the first rack.
It's going to come around the table nicely for the black. See if Ding can just not miss him, and then we'll be on to the next rack.
Ronnie O'Sullivan has it to do. The favourite, the main attraction. The star of the day, Ronnie O'Sullivan, is behind. Ding Junhui is a ton up. 109-9. The final perfectly set.
2 minutes.
Points to make up. Quite a handicap. Just more than two-thirds of the final remains. First frame took 14 seconds short of 9 minutes. And
Oh dear.
Cue ball the wrong side of the bot line.
That's a schoolboy error there from Ronnie, in fairness. He should make sure the white is in front or behind the line, so to speak. Michaela's bang on the case there, wasn't she?
One.
Well, that is a really contentious moment, right at the heart of the final.
Wow.
It could be decisive. It was a massive call.
Can you believe that?
Extraordinary.
Oh, Ronnie's not going to be happy about that one, is he? He's going to have to get himself together here. And well, if he gets a chance to get himself together. Ding's in here and...
Five.
Hang on a minute, where's this white going? Oh, he's had a little nice little flick off the red there. He's maybe a little bit better on the black than he would have been, but this is still tough.
Power ball tight to the right-hand cushion as we look.
Oh, he's played that well, hasn't he? Plum on this red here.
12.
Maybe drop this in for the blue.
Now this is the moment. This is what Michaela Tabb saw.
Well, in fairness, it was tough to see from where we're sitting, but Michaela obviously had a better look at it than what we did.
18. 19.
Well, the Rocket will be having nightmares about that one.
The ding is not allowing him the opportunity 26. To get back to the table and resettle. Just orthodox snooker now for the man from China.
27.
He's not too concerned with a power ball, such as his advantage.
See, the problem Ronnie's got here is Ding's queued up to break in the next rack as well, and that's a massive advantage, you see. So if he continues his
34.
Good run here, then Ronnie's going to have it all to do. Let's have a look at this.
It's a very tight call, isn't it? A very tight call.
Well, I think I'm going to sit on the fence on that one, to be honest.
Well,
it's really interesting because in the players' room, I think possibly while you were playing, Ali, Sean Murphy was talking, and Michaela was there as well, talking about if the ball's on the line, is it in, is it out, in terms of the power play and the power zone. And she says on the line is not quite sufficient. It has to be tipped the right side of the line to count as being in. And clearly, that is a line of thinking that she's put into practice.
Yeah, well, the Rocket's banging in, isn't he, now? He's got a power ball. He's got a chance to get back in this. Well, he doesn't want to finish straight on this red down the rail. He's going to have it all to do to get out on the black here, I think. Well,
26.
See, that's how well Ronnie O'Sullivan cues, isn't it? He's got right on the black there easily. Just stroked that red in like it was over the hole.
Really maximising his power play, as he has to do. 100 points down on the first rack. Disastrous start to the second rack. And he's back to within 100 points
42.
Now.
So what's he got here? Possible 34 points from now. So, yeah, if he manages to knock these in, which I think he will, with 1 minute 10 56. Seconds of power play time, that will mean that will count for nearly 70 points there. So, you know, Ronnie's banging it, isn't he, now?
60.
Left on the table, make
66.
That 44. He's going to be right up on Ding's shoulder.
74.
See, this table's so fast, but Ronnie's just got the cue ball and a bit of string. He just manages to be able to adapt to any conditions where the table's
84.
Fast or slow or whatever. Mind you, he's overrun that one. Commentator's curse. All the way around the table here.
He's got to come back.
Yeah, he's hit this perfect.
In a bit of a hurry.
He's hit this absolutely perfect.
96.
Wonderful. This for 100 break, which will add on. This will add on 50. To put him in the lead. Unbelievable. Unbelievable comeback from a catastrophic start for Ronnie O'Sullivan. And boy, we have a final now. O'Sullivan leading Ding by 169 to 151. It's been quite fast. The talk while you've been away has been between referee and player. An explanation from Michaela Tabb to Ronnie O'Sullivan about the award of a foul she contentiously gave against him at the start of the second rack. It was a very, very tight call.
Yes, it was, wasn't it? Ronnie's entitled to question the referee, but at the end of the day, the referee's decision is final. But there's one thing for certain, Ding will be making sure that his white ball is this side of the line.
Two.
He has he's potted from the break. That was worth two, and he has a glimpse at the power ball here, but there's no route to bottom right pocket.
Got a tough pink here in the middle. Yeah, he's cued that lovely. You know, it's funny this game, isn't it? Ronnie was 150 odd points behind earlier on, and now he's in front
Eight.
At the moment, even with that outrageous decision, shall we say.
Well, Ronnie made 160 points in the last frame with a ton break plus
Nine.
The 50 bonus that goes with it.
He's played that well, Ding, that red there for the pink. You can't see really him having too much trouble negotiating these open reds. Just got to keep the white ball under close control here, 15. Not get it travelling too far. I think he's come a little bit straight on this red by looks of things. He's playing this one behind the black to pop the black in the same hole as the red.
16.
We are halfway through the final. And Sullivan has a 2-point lead. That is all. Ding has a 5-point lead. That is all. At the halfway stage, this 23. Is beautifully balanced. Promises us the climax to the day that we had craved.
He's played that 24. Well. He's played a touch of left-hand side on that to get the right side of the blue. Just a little subtleties there of the game. Now he's on the power ball here. He's the right side of it to get on the pink. It's looking ominous now for Ronnie O'Sullivan in this rack.
29.
Now he has to cash in.
Oh, he's missed it. Can you believe he's missed that red? That was unbelievable. 29. There you go, you see, there's a little bit of tension there in the eye, which just shows these players are human, even if a red is over the hole. He could have popped that one with the other end of his cue.
An unthinkable miss from Ding Junhui. And salvation for Ronnie.
If only if that wasn't the power ball, we'd have probably got that. It just has that little extra bit of pressure.
All the focus on Ronnie. All the focus. Here's the power ball again.
7.
Yeah, now the rocket is lining up for this. You can't see him missing this, can you, really? Plum on the pink. He's away now.
9.
Ronnie's chance to run for the hills.
And he's running fast from to the hills as well.
21. 23.
Remember, double points here again, and if Ronnie were to make a century out of what remains here, which is achievable, then he would pick up another 100 bonus points for a second successive century.
37.
Yeah, that could make all the difference.
Oh, it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen.
He snatched at that one a little bit. Ronnie, you don't often see him do that.
And still 80 seconds of the power play left. Patricia Murphy's job is done. She stayed out of the eye of the storm, which her colleague Michaela Tabb walked into.
Does this red go past the brown? I think it does. It must be tight. He's looking twice.
Two.
Yeah, good chance here now for Ronnie. I think Ding, if he ends up losing this, I think he'll wonder how he has quite lost it, to be honest.
12.
Oh, he's going for his extension, is he, Ronnie?
Fourteen.
Used it well. And he has had a real chance. Ding to get away from the rocket. The rocket reeled him in and went past him. And he's now strolling, striding
26.
Away from him.
If he just gets this yellow in, it's going to be worth 4 points to him.
30.
Getting muddled up there with the power zone and power play and all sorts. There's all sorts going on there.
33.
Getting special attention from the crowd again.
Oh, they nearly talked him out of it there, didn't they? That wiped his feet.
Forty-two.
So the rocket now on the pink. Can't see anything going wrong now, can you?
48.
Well, we're going to reach the end of this rack with a third of the game still to play. 20 minutes more or less played, 10 still to play. Ronnie O'Sullivan with a lead of 81 points. And I'm going to put you, Ali, in the position of Ding now. Tactically, what is going through his head? What is he got to do, or should he just stick to his game, play snooker the way he plays snooker, and hope that the balls roll for him? Ding.
Well, it's ding to break next, so yeah, he's going to have a chance to make it. He's got to really capitalise on if the ball's split nicely, then, you know, get yourself onto the power ball as quick as he can and get potting them as fast as he can as well, because, you know, 10 minutes soon clocks down. If you get a little safety battle, that can go on for 4 or 5 minutes, you see, and then Ronnie's carrying a big advantage into this next rack.
On the whole, looking at the scoreboard, you would envisage that it would be in Ding's favour were this to
Thank
go
you.
Into a fourth
Ronnie
rack.
Sullivan to break.
He would choose a quick frame now.
Oh, sorry about that. I was misinformed there. It's the rocket to break. So I think we've got Ronnie's strong favourite here. He's just adjusting the cue ball there to make sure it's behind the line.
Well behind the line.
Oh, are you sure about that?
No danger of a second, no jump.
Oh, he's on the power ball straight away, look. Stun that in for the black, clear up, job done. It's as easy as that. I'm glad I'm sitting in the commentary box for once rather than out there trying to do it.
Well, now he does have a big chance to take it out of sight now.
Yeah, you can't see Rocket getting beat now, really. Stroke this black in. He's bang on the red. He could build up a really, really nice lead here.
16.
And Ronnie might be going home with all the cash tonight.
18 32 34.
See, this is where Ronnie O'Sullivan's cue ball control is so good here. You see where he's playing, he's just always plumb on the next ball. You know, he's bang on the black there. He's got a choice of reds here. He's slightly overscrewed that, to be
48.
Honest, but he's plumb on a red in the middle. He just cues the ball so well. You can never fancy him missing. It's very, very daunting as a player to play against
50.
Him because, you know, he just makes it look so easy, and it really is not that easy.
Yeah, he doesn't help the rest of you, does he?
He certainly don't. He's very, very talented, is Ronnie, and, you know,
62.
His cue ball control is spot on. He cues the ball so nice. You can't 64. See him missing for me now, can you?
71.
There we see some lovely cue ball control again.
78.
Choice of reds.
I hate to remind you, but he put
18.
Together 490 points against you in your semi-final. And there's every chance he could surpass that here.
Yeah, thanks for reminding me of that one. That's why I'm sitting here commentating and not there playing, unfortunately.
94.
But that's the way it goes.
96.
There we go, another century.
Yes, and an extra 50.
Yeah, he's just come out firing, isn't he, Ronnie?
108.
Got on the wrong side of a decision there from the ref, and he's put it to the back of his head. And capitalised on these chances big time.
109.
This is becoming vast now.
115. Yeah, he's running away with this now, I think.
115.
Ding's staring down the barrel here of a defeat, to be honest, even with 8 minutes to go. But you never know with these power balls, you know, get a big break in the next frame. But Ding's going to have it all to do, I feel.
Let's be truthful, he needs two big breaks, doesn't he? He needs two huge breaks, more than 300 points between them now, and 7 minutes still to play. I think one of the questions being asked in the players' room a little earlier was whether anyone could get to 1,000 points over the course of a half-hour session of power snooker. I'm quite sure it's conceivable. Ronnie's got to 7 more minutes after this to have a crack at it. Probably just about out of reach. But so is he now, and with that brown he goes to the highest score of the day.
Lovely cue in there again.
137.
This game's made for Ronnie, isn't it? This power snooker lock, it's all too easy.
143.
Very, very easy.
I can assure you all these people watching at home,
Sullivan,
you go down the your local club and try it. It's certainly not easy.
Another vast contribution from Ronnie O'Sullivan, who is past 500 points. There are still the better part of 7 minutes to play. Ding is back on 180. He might as well smile and enjoy. Have a word with the VIP spectators over his shoulder. Trophy over Ronnie's shoulder. £35,000 check waiting to be written out in his name.
Yeah, I should imagine he'll be banking that one first thing Monday morning, won't he?
Thank you. Ding Junhui to break.
Right, Ding's looking for a nice split here.
The sort of split that Ronnie had in the last frame.
Oh, where's the white ball gone here? He's got a little red behind the black there, I think. This is well missable, don't worry about that.
Well, he can't afford to miss.
No, he stroked that in nice.
One.
But looking at the scoreboard, it's tough to see a way back here for Ding. But there's one thing for certain, he won't be giving up out there. He'll be just trying to put all the balls and see what happens at the end of it.
Needs the power ball pronto.
Six.
If he puts this red here, ends up on the black, I'm not sure if the power ball will go past the other red into the same hole.
Seven.
He might just try and clear that red out of the way here and then play onto the power ball off the next black after this one. Ooh, not played that very well because he looks like he's going away from the black here.
14.
There you go, you see the table's so fast, it's 15. Got away from him, and now mind you, he can get back on the power ball here, just another way of doing it really. What do I know? I'm only a commentator.
Let me tell you, commentators know nothing. But well, you probably knew that already.
It's a good job I'm a snooker player, really. Oh.
22.
Now then. Cash in if you can. 300 points to make up
32.
In double quick time.
Right, if Ding gets his skates on here, he can knock a nice few in.
34.
And get another rack.
Come on, Ding, you need to be moving around the table a bit faster than that.
This needs to be athletic snooker.
The 48.
Is the impossible side of improbable.
50.
It's a 4 minutes 35 seconds coming down to now. He's got another 14 point black here. Tried to move that red off the cushion. Oh, he's just gone behind it, but he's okay here. He's on this other red.
64.
Fittingly enough, in terms of aggregate points, the final is certainly the heaviest scoring contest of the whole day.
66.
This is certainly making it interesting, isn't it, now?
78.
Well, he desperately needs to do this quickly enough to get another rack.
Oh.
But he,
Ding Junhui, 78.
Has to keep potting the balls. And therein lies the snag.
Yeah, he threw a little quick one in there, Ding. Ronnie's just going to be happy now to play a few safety shots, get the time down. Use the rules to his advantage, nothing wrong with that.
Another desperate, if understandable, hit and hope from Ding. And it invites Ronnie to polish the thing off.
One, two.
So he's going to knock the blue in here. Be in the power zone for this last red. Nice little angle on it needed.
12.
I think he's fell straight.
Be no consolation to Ding, but I think there'll be relief all round that
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 12.
Is going to win this despite the very controversial call at the start of the second rack. Imagine the inquest if that had, in the event, cost him the whole thing.
Yeah, in fairness, it's very nice that it hasn't come down to that decision now. That doesn't matter.
That was a...
Ronnie's capitalised on his chances and that doesn't come into it anymore. So that's a nice thing to happen.
Almost time for last orders at the back. Last couple of minutes, Ali, I think we know who's going to win it, so I'll ask you for a summary on the whole day, really, from a player's perspective. Is this going to catch on? Has it been fun? Have you felt comfortable with it? How would you change it?
I think it's got to catch on, hasn't it, really? The crowd have been great. They're loving it. The players, it's been great to be involved. There's going to be a few little tweaks. The table's been playing very, very fast. They might go back to using a traditional cloth, maybe. But yeah, it's been very well run.
Five.
Very, very good to be involved in the event. And
balance of crowd involvement just about right?
Yeah, I think so. It's been very interesting. You know, you've got to learn to deal with that. It's the first time there's been a tournament with this much crowd involvement. But us players are professional, we've got to deal with that. And we realise what the footballers have to put up with in their job.
12.
Yeah. When it gets personal?
Well, it can get a little bit personal, but, you know, that's the way of the world, isn't it? So we all have to deal with our little...
17.
Well, we are going to get a fourth rack. It's going to be academic. At least one assumes we are. Money is not generally in the business of missing from here. So we're going to get 67 seconds more. With Ronnie well out of sight, nearly 300 points clear. Ding Junhui fought gamely to stay somewhere in the same ballpark as him, but truth be told, what remains of the final of the first ever Power Snooker tournament is going to be little more than going through the motions and preparing an acceptance speech. Money's become a bit of a past master at taking possession of the check, as Ronnie.
Yeah, he'll be pleased with his day's work today, there's no doubt about that. It was difficult to see past him for a winner, really. That's probably hurts me a little bit to say that, playing in the same event. But,
thank you.
You know, this
Ronnie
sort of game is really cut out for Ronnie. He's such a good player, very fast player, very fluent, and he seems to be able to deal with anything that's thrown at him.
So one more crack at them.
So come on then, do you reckon Ronnie O'Sullivan can make a 147 in 56 seconds?
If anyone can, he can, but he can't.
One.
Well, I know he's good, but I don't think he's quite that good, unfortunately.
But it's been good enough today. An experimental day, an enjoyable day. A day upon which snooker can, one hopes, build. Not going to eclipse or delete the real thing, but it just might enhance it, it might decorate it, pretty it up around the edges, and engage a new sort of snooker spectator.
Oh, I think
Ronnie
that's
O'Sullivan
the final nail in the coffin now.
Power zone.
And Ronnie's in the power zone, how about that? 565 points.
Answer
for 258.
The end. Ronnie O'Sullivan has the power. The power and the glory. Power Snooker is launched on board the Rocket. Ronnie O'Sullivan is our first ever champion, winner in the final over Ding Junhui by 572 points to 258. It's been a lot of fun.
Yes, well
we have a winner.
O'Sullivan.
We have a winner. It was the winner many expected, but it wasn't as easy as perhaps a few predicted. I thought you were going to carry on there, son. You've done enough. 572, I think that's enough.
Yeah, you know, just say well done to Ding for getting to the final. You know, he's a class player and, you know, he suits his format as well. And, you know, it was 50-50 match, really. You know, he started off brilliant. But I was just happy to get in the game in the end, you know.
Did you just decide to make it hard for yourself by fouling on the break-off? Why aren't there?
Oh, I don't know. You know, they're just silly little errors that, you know, we're all new to this game. We're just getting used to it. But, you know, the fans here were great. I think it was just the pressure and and all that, you know. But just got to thank the fans and all the people that have come to watch today. You know, without them, we wouldn't have created the atmosphere that we have.
Well, no, we've loved the atmosphere. It's been a terrific day. Did it almost?
I'm disappointed. It's over.
Are you?
Yeah, I wanted to carry on.
Do you want to play someone else? There's a few takers.
We can play again if you like. Can play again?
Or double or quits?
Let's play again. Yeah, double or quits. I don't mind. It's all good.
I don't know if the Power Snooker Boys want to go double.
I don't want to go home yet.
I'm sure you'll find something to do with your evening. Well played to Ding. We're running out of time, so we should get the presentation party on stage to sort out the trophy and the cheque. The party, of course, comprises of the Power Girls and the chief executive of Power Snooker, Rod Gunner. If they could come up. It's all right, mate. I'm talking to the crowd. I don't know. Give us a wave, I think. Let me grab a quick word with Rod before we go. Well played, Din, by the way. Rod, how was the day for you before we get this trophy?
Absolutely fantastic. It was everything I hoped it would be. You know, we wanted the game to be fun, we wanted it to be fast, we wanted the audience participation, and boy, have they had a good day.
Oh, I think they've enjoyed it. Do you feel it's got a future? I mean, you would like to think so, of course, but...
A bit biased, aren't I? Yeah. So, but yeah, I think so. Well, look, do you think it's got a future?
Got a future, this game? I think you've probably picked another winner here, Ross.
I hope so, mate.
Well, listen, we should get the ceremony underway because that's what they're all waiting to see. Obviously, Ding picks up his runners-up check, which he's more than deserved. So, Ding, if you'd like to come up. Well played, Ding. Thank you very much. And the small matter of a cheque for £35,000 and the very first ever Power Snooker Trophy goes to who else? Ronnie O'Sullivan. You've won a few in your time, haven't you? Where does this sit?
To be honest with you, this is probably the one I've enjoyed the most. Because of the atmosphere, the fans, you know, everyone just seems to have had a great day today. And finally, I think snooker's got in the 21st century. You know, we've been kicking behind for a few years, you know, everyone else has been going forward. But finally, you know, Power Snooker's now a new format that is definitely here to stay. I want to be playing more of it. I'm sure the TV and the people have enjoyed it, so...
Well, we all thought you'd probably win it, did you feel? No. I mean, it's kind of made for you, this, isn't it?
I never feel I'm going to win anything, you know. I never go in with great confidence, but, you know... You know, it's a pot of brown.
I think they've had a drink, don't you?
Yeah, but it's...
But they've had a good day.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, you know, finally snooker's coming into the 21st century, and this is how it should be, you know. We're in the entertainment business, really.
Yes.
And I think tonight, every player, you know, has played their part, and, you know, I'm just pleased to be a small part of it.
Well played to you. Well played to everybody else here who's been a big part of this first day of Power Snooker. They've done well. He's done well. We'll see you again. Night from us.
I met you, we made a pact, broke promises, the system snaps, all your lies and neon lights are old. Glitter-coated mirrors.